seething. Hi, Juan. Over here.
It's Kara, isn't it?
So you do remember.
Why wouldn't I remember my own Valkyries?
It has been many ages since Odin, son of Bor, father of Thor, took his duties seriously. Instead, he frets about the future, tries to wriggle free of fate. That's what I hear.
Mind your words, girl.
Whatever you say, my lord and master.
Now, let's discuss your duties. This field of battle, does it bear fruit?
The harvest proves underwhelming. Many have died, but without valor. Unlike real heroes, they flaunt their wounds on their backsides, not their chests.
What use will there be to me when Ragnarok finally comes?
You have nothing to fear. I will make them ready for that final battle.
Perhaps I can help.
How?
Why, let my own battle prowess serve to inspire them.
You intend to tell them your old war stories? Not even we Valkyries believe in those fantasies anymore.
Then draw up an arena, so that I, Harvey, Lord of Asgard, patron to all true heroes, may reenact my finest moments. Just the way they happened.
This should be fun, if nothing else. So be it, lofty one, your arena awaits.
Let me see what rewards I am fighting for here.
Ah, the battle glory. You can't afford it anyhow.
Let me tell you a story.
Let's see what embellishments you add to this one. How disappointing. Farewell, Lord of Asgard.
Dark is the shadow thrown, and disorder of the land dethroned. Plans tangle as they go down, a stubborn monarch's head uncrowned. Fiercely eyed and flaming pride, merciless men are called to strive. With fire in heart rode the warrior forth, to redden the roads of Repton. The king's guard struck by shame, loss has robbed reputed name. No matter what our hero choose, I fear that there is none to lose. Award him life or incite the kill. His days remain few numbered still.
not to draw attention here. Malevolence. This land bears deep affliction. Thank you. Kya!
This place is heavily guarded. A child's innocence, my boy. I pray he has it still after all of
of this. These dwarves, I need them. Though it chafes me to admit it. Be gracious, Harvey. Humble and patient. The dwarves.
Greetings, Harvey. Looking for some work, yes? Freda offers much to choose from. Don't be a stranger.
No, yes, Freda was still alive.
Do you still
have me stuck down here?
Oh, an Asya! Me, oh my! Oh, you out followed, were you?
Songs of my deeds follow me. My enemies do not.
Well, if you're sure. Not many know this place, not even the other dwarves. That's how we'd like to keep it.
You prize your secrecy here, even more than other dwarves I've met.
Well, of course. They'd only just discovered this place when the invasion began. Those of us nearby were herded in quick. Best thing we can do now is to keep our heads down. Don't need strangers going in and out, bringing who knows what to our door.
I am no friend to Muspel or Jotun.
Glad to hear it. See that it stays that way.
Enough of this.
Close my eyes, I can imagine I am back in my favorite tavern in Uldar. Oh, sweet mead, dry ale, pickled acorns.
Were you followed?
Another one. No, don't worry. I'll be careful this time. Yes, no need to remind me. Though it was only a little blood.
Who are you talking to?
Shh. Can you hear us? I'm speaking to no one, good sir. Take a seat. Let me get my needles and blades. You've found a new design for me.
You spoke of voices when none are to be heard. Are you moon-touched?
Voices? The very idea that crystals can talk and that they would be speaking to me. It is you who is mad for even suggesting it.
I made no mention of crystals.
Ah, that's because they don't talk to you. You're not special.
I think you have been down here a very long time. I might just try elsewhere.
Who goes there?
I am Harvey, Lord of Asgard.
You. You're a long way from home. Or are the Aesir now invading us as well, jailer of Ivaldi?
Ivaldi owes me his freedom. Where is he? I would speak with him.
Be my guest. I assume you know the way to Helheim.
He's dead. How?
How else? Or do you need both eyes to see the Muspels everywhere? That was uncalled for. I... Walk with me. I am Gunnborg, leader of this shelter. Or what remains of it now Ivaldi is gone. He was trying to make contact with the other shelters. There was an ambush, Glott's soldiers, and... something else. Something worse. A creature of fire and fury. It devoured Ivaldi home.
No doubt Brett in Searcher's dungeons. Perhaps Loki's aid before I could make him my captive.
You and your captives. Regardless, Uldar fell soon after Ivaldi did. Our mines and miners. Any survivors now serve Glott.
Is that name meant to mean anything to me?
Glaud is Sutor's bastard son. Half Muspel, half Jotun. A nightmarish being. Capable of tearing a dwarf in two.
An unthinkable end for anyone. Whether warrior or otherwise.
I saw it with my own eyes. I still see it when I try to sleep.
And yet, Glaud has not simply slaughtered your people. He needs your miners. To what end?
The invaders hunger for secrets buried deep in the ground. Ancient relics. The Muspels place great importance in them.
And how do you know this?
Enough, Javi. We have suffered enough. Now I must endure all these questions.
Aid me with your knowledge, and I shall strike a blow against Glaud and all Muspels.
In Ullnor, we had someone gathering information for us. The miner, Frithjofr. He's been silent for days now, which is unlike him. Probably dead for all I know.
Anything sought by the Muspels must be mine. Where was Frithjofr last seen? Perhaps I can find him.
There is a house in Ullnor. Its owners killed by Muspels long ago. There we would exchange messages with him.
This house? How do I find it?
It's the tallest house in the Jeweler's District, by the city's south gate. Just look for the gold in the streets. You'll see.
Frithjofr may be the key to obtaining these relics Suther seeks. I must find him.
Do as you must, Lord of Asgard. I have too many burdens of my own to worry about yours as well.
Be saved, and his mother avenged. Loki and I, we brought Baldur here once, to Uldo, when he was just a boy. Now both are captives. Loki deservingly, by my hand, and Baldur by Suttur's.
Should not be seen in this area.
Go, Zulin. I remember this was a lively city once. A place of great happiness. Gold in the streets.
Must be blocked from the other side.
Gold in the streets. The house of Sieg should be close. This is where Gunnvorg told me to look. What happened here? The artisans who once worked here. Their life's work. How trivial these trinkets must seem now, given all that has happened. For every occasion. This building surely played host to important moments in the lives of many. And look at it now.